How'd you figure that out? Now move on to the next column. Pretty good. Now on to the next column place. Wow, you're good. You got the first lock. Two more to go. All right, you got two locks. Just one more. You did it. I knew Polly couldn't keep us out. What's wrong? Are you having second thoughts about helping me save the world? Are you still with me? I can't do it without you. It looks like you have to solve an addition problem to open this lock. That's no problem for you. This time you'll have to solve a subtraction problem. Good luck. You'll need to know how to multiply to solve this problem. Ready? To figure out the combination, start by entering the correct number in the bottom tile of the ones column. To increase the number on the tile, click on the up arrow at the top of each tile, or click on the down arrow to go backwards. If you want, you can also enter numbers using your keyboard. When you think you have the correct number in the correct column, click on the button below that number. If your answer is correct, the button below the next column will light. When each equation is solved, one of the combination locks on the door will open. This door is shut tight until we juice up. Time to head to the professor's generator. The lock won't work without energy. Let's go to the generator to power up. We've got to go to the generator. This place is dead. This is the door to the kitchen. Everyone eats here. Polly, her dad, and of course, all us robots. The professor put a lock on it months ago because some of the robots were getting a little gluttonous. I mean, they'd eat all the time if they could. I used to know the combination, but it looks like Polly's changed this lock. You can figure out the combination if you can figure out the math problems that appear on the door. That's Mort peeking out from inside. He's one of the nicer robots around here, but he gets a little cranky when he hasn't eaten. I'm not sure what Polly has planned for us inside, but we need to get beyond this door. Click on the arrows on the tiles at the bottom of the equation. The up arrows will increase the number. The down arrows will decrease it. When you think you've got the correct number in the tile, click the glowing enter button beneath it. If you want, you can also enter numbers using your keyboard. Then press enter. Well, the door's locked again. Time to figure out the combinations to those locks. Of course, the door's still locked, but you'll have no trouble getting the combination. Is it too much to ask for people to leave the doors unlocked around here? Well, we can figure out the combination again. Click on the arrows on the tiles at the bottom of the equation until the correct number is displayed. I don't think that number's right. Try again. Try again. Nope, that's not right.
The ones place is for all numbers less than 10. In an equation like this, the ones place is the first column from the right. On this door, the second column from the right is the tens place. A 1 in the tens place stands for 1 10. A 2 in the tens place stands for 2 tens or 20, and so on. The third column from the right is the hundreds place. A 1 in this column stands for 100. A 2 in this column stands for 200, and so on. Thank goodness you're here. My stomach's rumbling, and I don't know how to cook. I'll say you do. Polly has left me in charge of something very important. There's a clue in here, but you have to feed me first. I'm so hungry. You certainly do. Because Polly has left me in charge of some invention points you'll need, and I'll hand them over if you feed me well. I'll even try to help you out, anything to speed up my lunch. I know a lot about math, and I'm famished. To subtract numbers in a column, you have to subtract the numbers for each place value, beginning with the ones place. It looks like the number on the bottom is too big to be subtracted from the number on the top. That means we'll have to borrow from the tens column. Click the top tile of the column you want to borrow from. Now, click the top tile of the column you want to add the borrowed amount to. 10 ones have been borrowed from the tens column and added to the ones column. Now, you can subtract the numbers in the ones place. That means we'll have to borrow from the hundreds column. 10 tens have been borrowed from the hundreds column and added to the tens column. Now you can subtract the numbers in the tens place. To add numbers in a column, you have to add the numbers for each place value, beginning with the ones place. You added the numbers correctly, but the result is too big to fit on one tile. So we need to carry the extra amount to the next column. Okay, Now the extra amount in the ones place has been carried over to the tens place. Okay. Now the extra amount in the tens place has been carried over to the hundreds place. That's right. But that number is too big to fit in the hundreds place. So we have to move the extra amount to the next column. That's the thousands place. Oh, please hurry. I'm faint with hunger. I'm so glad you're here. My blood sugar's dropping. Hurry, hurry, hurry! I'm growing weak with hunger. To multiply numbers in a column, you first have to multiply the number on the bottom with the ones place of the number on the top. And then you have to multiply the number on the bottom with the tens place of the number on the top. You multiplied the numbers correctly, but the result is too big to fit on one tile. So we need to carry the extra amount to the next column. Okay, now the extra amount in the ones place has been carried over to the tens place. Okay, now the extra amount in the tens place has been carried over to the hundreds place. That's right, but that number is too big to fit in the hundreds place. So we have to move the extra amount to the next column. That's the thousands place.